Lights and Omnes. Today we're looking at book four, lines 189 to 218. And this is the finishing up of the Fama passage and also Yarbus. All right? So Hike, we start off here, is Fama. Okay? So Hike, Reclaybots. This creature filled up the people with various talk then. Gaudiens, it's referring back to Hike, rejoicing. Okay? And equally saying facta et infacta, fact and fiction, or true things and untrue things. And this is what she said, indirect statement. Okay? And this is talking about Aeneas and Dido. So everyone's talking about what had happened in the cave and now that they're living together. Okay? Aeneas had come, Cretum, sprung from Trojan blood. All right? To whom Dido deemed, this is present tense, of course, deemed herself, or beautiful Dido deemed herself worthy to join the man. So to which man, it's a relative adjective, and it's going with weird. To which man beautiful Dido deemed herself worthy to join in marriage, or in a relationship anyways. Alright? And then keep going this. Now this you have to unpack it a little bit, alright? So if you look here, it says, Nunc hymen, now. And this is accusative of time. Now for the whole winter, okay, amongst themselves in luxury, however long it is. Okay, so what's been left out here is Dido and Aeneas are the accusative subject. So Dido and Aeneas foere, cherish themselves now for the whole winter among themselves in luxury, however long it is, as long as it is. This has been left out, okay? So this is accusative, ablative, luxu, and foeres are infinitive, okay? And then we have immores, okay? Finally, we get our accusative subject here. So forgetful, and this is forgetful of the kingdom, and captured by a base desire. So this amour that they have is cupidity, is desire. Alright? This goddess immediately poured these foul things into the faces of the men. And there we go. And straightway she turned her courses to King Yarbus. Yarbus, of course, is a king of North Africa, so a neighbor of Dido. So, and we'll find out that he wanted to marry her. And she said, no, I'm not going to marry him. And then now he's a little upset. And Fama incendit quae, inflamed the spirit with words and heaped up the angers. All right, we'll see what keeps going here. Then... So this man sown begotten, we could say. It's a PPP describing Yarbus. Begotten from Haman or Amun and the seized nymph, Garnadian nymph, so a nymph, a local nymph. Okay, so this man, he's telling us whose parents were. Now, he's related to Jupiter. Hamon, or Amun, is another word for Jupiter. The Greeks and Romans say so. And what did he do? Oh, my goodness, he posuit. He placed 100 temples to Jupiter. Immense temples. And where did he put this? In his Lactis Regnis, in his wide kingdom. And he placed 100 altars. And he consecrated a sacred fire. And he consecrated the eternal feasts or couches of the gods. So they have couches, and he's temples. He's done all these great things for Jupiter, all right? And he also consecrated the rich earth, okay? Pinguine is third declension adjectives, ends in an E. It's accusative, all right? And he did that. He consecrated the rich earth with the blood of the flocks. And he consecrated the flowery thresholds with various reefs. So he's built these temples, he built all these altars, and he keeps them together. I mean, so he's done all these things. Now, of course, there's the whole principle of and I'll put this down, of do ut des. All right, this is part of the portion of Roman religion. I give so that you give. All right, so he's done all these things for Jupiter. And according to that philosophy, Jupiter, and he's also the son of Jupiter, Jupiter owes him. All right, so this man, amen. So this is literally amens, from mens, his mind, so it's like crazy. So this man, crazy of the mind, and inflamed, PPP, dominant, inflamed by the bitter rumor, rumore amaro. He has said, dicitur. What's he said to do? We can even infinitive. Oh, he has said to orase. This is a perfect infinitive that's been contracted. To have prayed before the altars among the middle divine powers of the gods. So amongst the statues. And he said to have begged many things, multa, of Jupiter. Okay. Of Jupiter. With his upraised hands. And he did this suplex humbly. So he's there praying to Jupiter, doing all these things. And he says, Jupiter omnipotens. Okay. Jupiter, all-powerful Jupiter. Qui nunc Mauritia. All-powerful Jupiter, to whom... the Mauritian people, having feasted, this is a perfect participle component, having feasted on painted couches, pours Linnaeum honor. Okay? So Jupiter, so they do all these things for you, these festivals for you. Auspicus hike. Do you see these things? Okay. He says, and you, Father, okay, this is accusative, when you twist or throw lightning bolts, in vain, Horimus, in vain we fear you, blind fires in the clouds terrify our spirits and mix empty murmurs. So it's like, are we afraid of you when all these things are happening? You know, if you're not going to do anything. So it's pretty, he's calling Jupiter out of here a little bit, all right? And then he talks about Dido. Okay? He says a femina. Okay, a woman. And we have a relative clause here, who, wandering in our lands, okay, placed a city little in worth, okay, to whom we have given a shore to be plowed, and to whom we have given laws of the place. So we've given her a place and laws. We've done all these things for her. And what has she done? That she, the femina, repels our marriage. Now singular for the plural, or plural for the singular. And receives Aeneas as a dominus into her kingdoms. Alright? So receives Aeneas as a lord. And then he gets nasty here, and he says, et nunc ille course, is Aeneas. But she's calling him like another Paris. And that Paris, okay, with his half-man group, all right, having some nexus, this is a perfect participle, taking a Greek accusative or accusative of respect, having tied his chin with a Maronian turban, and having tied his chin and his dripping hair, so his hair is dripping with perfume, okay? That Paris is obtaining his plunder or his seized thing. So Dio is like a seized thing. We indeed bear gifts to your temples and we favor your empty vein. So we've done all these things for you and you just haven't done anything for us. All right. So there we go. Valete omnes linguatina est vita.